Hey, what's up YouTube? Baseball Tradition 46 here, and today we got a special vid for you guys. As you can see, we're out in the outdoors. We're having a fire. It's right there.
Started by the best, of course.
And this is a special vid, and it's in tribute of the greatest manager of all time. And what's his name, Cam?
Sparky Anderson.
That's right. Just give you a little background. Sparky died November 4th, 2010, which is not too long ago. And you know what? He was one of the greatest managers alive. So right now, while Cam's feeding the fire, we are gonna pack a lip, and we're gonna pack it in honor of Sparky. So right now, we're gonna let you guys watch the smoke my eyes. Watch the tribute. So here you go.
Every day, a lonely man and his guitar. In his eyes, I see the pain, all the faces and the places, all the trouble that it seems. There was a time, there was a day, they come from starts to fade. Suddenly the pain slowly fades away. Tattered, torn and frayed, there's a place within his heart he'll always save. A song in motion. We'll be right back.
that's a clip for you guys. That's a little tribute for the late Sparky Anderson. Hope you guys enjoyed it. You know what, Cam, he was a great manager, don't you think?
Mm-hmm.
Even though we didn't see any of his games, his last game was, let me see, I got some stats here. And we're going to be reading them off later. I'm just going to put it, his last game was September 27th. 1959 as his final game, and you know what? Like, we weren't even born yet.
Yeah.
But there is still a place for big superstars in the MLB in our hearts. So, yeah. So Cam, let's give him a little bit of stats.
All right.
We got some stats here, and we'll switch back and forth. I'll start off. Sparky was born on February 22nd, 1934, in Bridgewater, San Diego. So for all you San Diego people out there that are from Bridgewater or anywhere around that area, I know you probably have a special place in your heart for Sparky if you've watched some of his games.
He played the same position as I do now. He's a two-bagger, second baseman.
Yeah, his high school was Dorsey in Los Angeles, California. He was he was inducted into the Managers Hall of Fame by the Veterans Committee in 2000.
He managed 17 years.
17.
17 years seven. With the Detroit Tigers.
And he also managed 9 years with the Cincinnati Reds. Now, with the Cincinnati Reds, and we'll go through a whole list. This will probably take us a little while, but it's interesting because, you know what? This is special to us, and this guy was a role model to any manager out there right now. In 1970, with the Cincinnati Reds, he won the NL pennant, okay?
Don't mind the smoke either. The fire's dying out, but
yeah.
Continue.
72, with the Reds again, he won another NL pennant. 75 with the Reds, he won a World Series championship, and 76, so back-to-back World Series championships for the Cincinnati Reds in 75 and 76. But right there.
At 84, he played with the Detroit Tigers, and there again, World Series champs. Cincinnati Reds, 9 years, 4 pennants, 2 World Series titles. Now, you gotta admit, for a guy of his age, that is solid.
Yeah, and he started managing at about the age, I'm pretty sure, at 76. 1970, he started managing, and he started at the age of 36. With the Detroit Tigers, he went 17 years with 1 pennant, and 1 pennant and 1 World Series title. All right. So in 84, he managed the Detroit Tigers for a total of 17 years with 1 pennant, 1 World Series title. For a total of 26 years, he managed both teams. He managed 4,030 games with 5 pennants and 3 World Series titles. In the All-Star game, he managed the National League in 71, 73, 76, and 77. He managed the AL in 85. Awards, why don't you read that off?
In 84, he won Manager of the Year. 87, he won the American League Manager of the Year.
And, that's a little insight for you.
Yeah.
So that's basically what I had to talk about. This is just a little tribute, and so enjoy.
That was a good experience.
And Sparky Anderson, you will always be in our hearts.
We'll remember you, buddy.
Yeah.
Rest in peace.
All right, and remember our motto, spit black
and never hold back.
See you later.